A final note about the Supreme Court and the justice who's quickly becoming, in the eyes of many legal scholars, the conscience of the court, Sonia Sotomayor. She went on record this week during oral arguments in the Mississippi abortion case, calling out the politics that brought the abortion ban to the nation's highest bench, citing her own observation of how states are passing ever stricter abortion laws, explicitly inspired by the court's new conservative majority. Here's Justice Sotomayor in her own words.
Will this institution survive the stench that this creates in the public perception that the Constitution and its reading are just political acts?
Will it survive the stench, she asks. As Ruth Marcus writes for the Washington Post, quote, this was no spur-of-the-moment comment. Stench was a word deliberately chosen, calibrated to the perceived danger of the moment, studiously oblivious to whether it would antagonize colleagues. It was the equivalent of shouting fire in an uncrowded courtroom, not so much to those present, but to a live streaming nation. It wasn't just that S word that made a mark. Sotomayor also pounding lawyers arguing in favor of Mississippi's ban and overturning Roe, asking the state solicitor general, quote, how is your interest anything but a religious view? What are the advancements in medicine that could justify abandoning Roe versus Wade? And quote, when does the life of a woman and putting her at risk enter the calculus? While a decision has yet to be announced, the court's conservative majority seems certain to uphold Mississippi's prohibition on abortion, helping cement that fear, the fact that the Supreme Court decided this week to uphold the abortion ban in Texas. The justices, however, ruling the law can be challenged in court. Dissenting in the Texas case, Justices Sotomayor, Kagan, and Breyer, writing the Texas abortion law is, quote, an unconstitutional scheme enacted in open defiance of women's rights, a madness that the Supreme Court should have put to an end months ago. That by allowing the law to continue, the court, quote, betrays not only the citizens of Texas, but also our constitutional system of government. It's that language, it's that courage to address the stench within our own ranks that has many, like Harvard legal scholar Lawrence Tribe, declaring Sotomayor the conscience of the court, and a brilliant one at that, calling her one of President Obama's greatest contributions, which Congresswoman Nydia Velazquez agreed with, but with a reminder, highlighting a letter the scholar wrote in 2009 to then-President Obama, describing Sotomayor as, quote, not nearly as smart as she seems to think she is, adding this hard truth, that when it comes to women of color, we have to prove ourselves every single day. Indeed. And may this moment and this evolution of opinion, which I welcome, remind us that often the person who describes a woman of color as overestimating her own ability is actually underestimating how her life experience allows her to understand the stakes, requires her to be a truth teller, and prepares her to be the conscience of an institution.